You don't have to do this.
Here I come.
Years away from this place and it's still the same piece of shit. Cindy, how did you get me come back?
I came here with Mark. He joined us because he wanted to.
No, he joined us because I convinced him.
Hey. So, you guys want to get out of here or you just want to fry in the sun all day?
Beautiful place, huh?
I should have come earlier to see him.
Hey. There was no way you could have known. Don't blame yourself for this.
This place is beautiful.
And old.
Stop it, Nathan.
Hey, Jen, you want to come help with this?
Sure.
Finally. Let's hit the pool.
Jen, wait.
Come on. I want to soak up the sun.
After you, m'lady.
Silly. Thanks for coming.
You're welcome. Looks like the children left the bags for us to carry. Oh, what a mess. It smells like mold.
Bet the house was already like this while he was still living in it.
Oh, I doubt it. Who would live like this?
You didn't know my father.
Are you scared of the water or of me?
Little of both, I guess.
Hey. Hey, can you hear me? Are you coming or not?
He was hoping you'd come back, wasn't he?
You almost gave me a heart attack.
Baby, you need to relax. You are way too stressed.
I know.
Come on. You'll feel better after a massage.
See, somebody tidied up the place. Now I know who to call when I need housekeeping.
Ha ha ha. You could have helped, couldn't you?
I would have loved to, but your friend here wouldn't give me a break.
Oh, sure.
So, why does everything look so odd in this place?
Because it's a commune and my father liked to keep it that way.
I see. Wanted to keep the bohemian vibe, huh?
So how's the pool water?
It was amazing. He didn't need was too shy, you know?
I wasn't shy, all right? I just wasn't in the mood. By the way, I saw one of those ridiculous scarecrows out there. You remember those?
Yeah, wow, I do.
What do you mean scarecrows?
Oh, you wouldn't believe it, man. Now, they're not called scarecrows. I can't remember what they're called, but they don't scare crows, right? Instead, they're meant to scare away spirits.
Spirits?
Oh, yeah.
Should we make a toast? Mm?
To the haunted scarecrows.
Stop, Benet. Isn't funny.
Scared?
Stop. Mm-hmm.
Cindy!
Hey, it's Adam!
You look so beautiful.
How are you? It's been so long.
Hey, Cindy. This is for you. Sorry, Father. No one showed up around here since Bob. But then we saw the car and we thought...
You look just like your mother.
Thank you. I want to introduce you to my friends. This is my boyfriend, Mark, and that's Jennifer and Nate.
Howdy.
Nate used to come here a lot when he was a kid. Do you want to eat with us?
No, we don't want to bother you.
We have cold beer.
No, we don't want to intrude. We just dropped by to say hi.
I guess we could stay just for a little while.
Okay, maybe just a little bit. So, how long are you planning to stay?
Just a few weeks. We wanted to really use this time to relax, you know, to unwind a bit.
So, you know Cindy since she was a little kid, right?
Yes. Cindy was an adorable baby.
Yeah. Bob and I grew up in this place. This was just a small commune, you know, like very humble place.
Sure, you lived like real hippies.
His grandpa used to come here a lot on business, right, Nate?
Yeah, I guess so. He used to bring me along with him. I was pretty young.
Your grandfather wasn't a very affable person, you know.
Beth, I guess that depends on how you look at it. Because in his opinion, you were all hillbillies. Come on, it was a joke. What?
Stop it, Nathan.
Beth, we really gotta go.
Just one more thing. I think you should be very careful when you go out at night.
Why?
Beth. Okay. Bye, kids.
Bye.
Jesus.
Ridiculous. Nathan, Jennifer. Hey, lovebirds, we're going out to the pool. Or you can stay in there.
Hey, Mark. So, how long before we die of boredom in this godforsaken place? Mark? Anybody home? Mark?
Yeah, I just remembered I forgot my glasses.
Come in.
Nathan? What the?
Nate, we're gonna go for a stroll.
Okay.
Nathan!
What? Where'd they go?
For a walk? Why?
Nothing.
Jesus, this is horrible. Weren't you afraid of those things?
Of course I was, but Nathan was more afraid than I was.
Really? Good to know, Mr. Butch.
I miss this place. I always felt like my dad didn't want me around.
Yeah. Such a beautiful place. I wish I could stay here forever. What's there?
One of those houses built for the hippies, like Nate calls them. Sometimes we played hide and seek here. Scared shitless of this place.
But were the houses already empty at the time?
One of the workers died here. Others left here, you know? Anyway. Jen?
Hey, girl! Get me out of here! I'm innocent!
You bitch, this isn't funny.
Come on, woman!
I haven't smelled pussy since they locked me up.
Oh, God. Come on, Princess Leia.
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just a shiver.
You're too stressed out. I think we should drink something relaxing.
Maybe you're right.
I guess I need it too.
Oh, yeah? May I know why? Oh, Prince Charming.
I think it's time for us to take this relationship to the next level, you know?
Does he know that?
Nathan is a nice guy. He acts all snobbish, but he has a kind heart.
He suffered a lot when his grandfather died. Was his hero. So it made him bitter.
What about you and Mark?
No, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him.
I can't imagine.
What about that drink?
He's waiting for us at the house. Let's go.
I think I've had enough, guys. I need to go to shower.
Sounds like a good idea.
Ooh, shower party.
Man, you're silly.
Nathan.
Shoot.
I want to show you something. I want to surprise Cindy.
You're serious?
Yes.
Oh, that's so corny. You guys barely know each other. You wanna give her the cereal box ring? Think about it. This place is such a trip, huh?
Stop it.
What? I mean, look at this. It's like they're living in the dark ages.
Hey, where were you?
Look what I found upstairs.
Ooh, throw this away.
Cindy wasn't allowed to have any Barbies, so she had to play with these dolls.
Stop it.
What are you talking about?
Cindy, what's wrong?
I guess she doesn't like Barbies anymore.
Get rid of that, Mark. I don't want that in this house.
But it's just a doll.
And ugly as shit.
But what is this? Jeez.
I don't care, Mark. Throw it far away.
Okay, okay. Yeesh, sorry.
Thank you.
Cindy, I'm sorry. It shouldn't end like this.
Dad?
What happened, baby? Hey, calm down. You okay?
Yeah.
Cindy. Baby, talk to me. What's wrong?
It was just a nightmare. This place is messing with my mind.
Clutter never ends, huh?
Tidiness wasn't my dad's forte.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Looking for anything specific?
The house documents, mainly.
Hey, check this out. This farm's land was a gift?
Mm-hmm. As a payment of services rendered, I think. I was small, my dad wouldn't tell me those kind of things.
Is this your dad?
Their house was in the woods and they lived off this land. Then Ethan's grandfather bought everything off and put them here. In return, they would farm the land as in a partnership.
Huh.
What?
Your dad. He looks like a leader. Look at that. I have a better idea. Why don't we... Come
Hey, sleepyhead.
Good morning.
What time is it?
Around 1 p.m.
I passed out.
Mm-hmm.
You deserve it, girlfriend. They wanted to wake you up, you know, but I didn't let them. Let's enjoy the day.
Can see the boys are already enjoying it.
Who would have thought that this old city boy would eventually find himself enjoying this godforsaken country?
Well, my grandpa always used to say that when things start to look gloomy, crack open a beer. I was a man of vision.
What did he do?
My grandpa? Business, Mark.
Yeah, but what kind of business?
Opportunities, you know, and I guess an agribusiness popped up out here, and that's what drove him out into the middle of nowhere.
Your grandfather got rich over here, Nate. You know that, right?
Yeah, well, that doesn't mean he liked living in this rat hole.
Rat hole? Really, Nate? I don't like when you talk like that. My father raised me here.
I didn't mean it that way. It came out wrong.
Sure, if it isn't the way you like things, it's shit, right?
Hey, we should do a toast, To our trip, to your father, To Robert.
To Robert.
To Robert. Woo! Hey, guys. I'll be right back. I knew you would come back for your baby. You're so hot.
So you think...
Jen? Jen? Jen!
Okay, Jen, calm down. What happened?
There was someone in here trying to smother me.
Jen, there's someone else here. You must have choked.
No, I was attacked, I'm sure.
It's over. It was just a scare.
It wasn't just a scare, it was attacked.
Okay, fine. Let's all just calm down.
I'm gonna go get some water.
What the hell was that?
I don't know, Mark, but I'm scared.
Oh, no, don't worry. She just had a little bit too much to drink and had a breakdown or something.
Nobody drinks that much and thinks they were attacked. There's something wrong. What?
Well, there's no one else here besides us. I don't understand how someone could just walk in and...
Beth, you scared me.
What happened?
It was Jen. She had a breakdown, I think.
It wasn't a breakdown. She says she was attacked. Is there anybody else here?
She said someone tried to choke her.
Choke her? Well, if everything is okay, I'm gonna go back home. Excuse me.
Oh, Beth, may I walk you to your house?
Have a seat. I made some tea.
No, thank you. Jen seemed really hysterical. She honestly believed that someone attacked her.
It's chamomile. It's good for the nerves.
Something's going on, Beth, and it's not just Jen. Everyone's been acting a little weird. Hell, even I am.
What do you know about Cindy in this land?
Not much. I know that Robert acquired a house from a group of people, and that Nathan's grandfather was the owner. They were in business together. Agribusiness.
Don't touch that.
Oh, I was just curious. Well, why?
You have no respect for us and our beliefs. You're always sticking your nose into other people's business.
I'm sorry, is that Cindy in that photo?
Yes. I always pray for our little girl. Since she left, I know her father protected her, but you know, you can never be too safe.
Protect her from what?
The drowned.
Daring the kid, Beth? Hi, Mark.
Hey, Adam.
Mark told me about problems, and weird things are happening.
Oh. But
really uncanny resemblance, right? That's Caroline, Cindy's mother.
Who are the others?
Well, that's Bob, Cindy's father, and the handsome one over there is me.
What about this one?
That's William.
Yeah, we all lived here in the commune when it was just the forest.
What happened to him?
Oh, he left a long time ago. He was an idealist, combative, idealist.
He's dead. He wants revenge. Revenge.
Hey, Mark, let me take you home. Come on. Later, Beth.
Drake. It's all his fault.
No, Mark. Don't pay too much attention to what Beth says. She ain't feeling good in the head, know what I mean?
Yeah, but Adam, could she be right? I mean, Jen's situation is one thing, but I think something's going on with me, too. I've been seeing things, and I think I wouldn't be surprised if the others were, too. And then there's the scarecrow things and the puddles and that weird, creepy, tied-up doll I found in the attic the other day. It's just too much to be a bunch of coincidences.
Wait. Did you say doll?
Yeah, it was all tied up. What is that, some kind of ritual or something?
Yeah, but Bob did do some witchcraft to protect Cindy. That's what he told me. So what'd you do with the doll?
Oh, well, they all yelled at me, so I went to the pier and threw it in the lake.
You threw it in that lake?
Yeah? Why?
Mark, whatever you're doing here, finish it fast. It's not safe for Cindy here anymore.
Well, what did she mean about Drake?
Later, Mark.
Fuck.
God damn it. Goddamn kid. Of all places, had to throw in the fucking lake. Oh, damn it.
So did you talk to her?
I tried to find out if there was someone else here at the farm. I don't know. Some kind of suspect or something we could talk to.
And?
It seems that Beth isn't exactly in her right mind.
Yeah, I think so too. I'm gonna go for a run. Wanna come?
Oh, I was thinking we would finish going through your dad's old stuff. I don't know, just to get it over with once and for all. What do you say?
No problem. See you soon.
Well, don't go too far. Stay on the premises.
Looks like you drowned.
Yeah. No marks. Nothing. Or it could have been a heart attack.
We need to call the police.
We need to tell Beth. We can make the call from her place.
I think we should get out of here.
Nathan's right. We need to talk to her.
No fucking way.
Jen, we need to talk to Beth.
I'm not going. I'll be waiting for you guys at the house with all my stuff packed up. Let's go, Nate.
We'll be right back. All right, it'll be quick.
You're not going with me?
Cindy needs our help. She just lost a friend, Adam. Remember him?
Who's gonna help me?
Jen. Jen!
Beth, I'm so sorry.
Beth, we need to call the police.
Never get here in time!
Beth, please calm down. I know it's a difficult moment.
Wait,
but
what do you mean they don't get here in time? In time for what?
Don't you know the story? Your grandfather never told you. You know who killed Adam!
Beth, you're scaring me.
We are all dead.
Let's get the fuck out of here. We can call from the house.
We are doomed. Doomed. He's taken by a deep hatred. He won't stop until he gets his revenge.
Who?
The drowned, Cindy. The drowned.
That's fine, Jen. Get out of here.
For the first time, I agree with you.
No one can help you. No one can help you. No one can help you.
Crazy bitch.
What if she's right? What if this drowned guy did it?
What? Seriously? The old man drowned in booze. Wake up!
Can we please get out of here?
Jen's right. We got nothing to do with all this, and if we don't leave soon, they could blame us.
Blame us for what?
Just calm down, everyone. We're all too nervous.
Shit. It's dead.
That's enough. I'm getting out of here.
Jen, wait.
Nathan. What did she mean about your grandpa's story?
Excuse me, I want to check on Jen.
No, wait a minute, answer me. He had something to do with this guy's death, didn't he? What do you know about it?
Absolutely nothing. I wasn't even born at the time. Now get out of my way.
Nathan!
Jen, you don't have to do this.
I'm sorry, Cindy.
I'm just as upset as you are, Jen. We came here to help Cindy, and it was an accident. He drowned.
I won't spend another minute in here, Nathan.
Jen, please calm down. Please.
so wrong.
She's right. There's something on this farm, I know there is. Mark, you're being a jackass. Maybe you should help Cindy instead of buying into this paranoia.
She's all you care about, right, Nathan? What about me?
What are you talking about?
Do you think we're all idiots?
Calm down, Jen, it's not what you're thinking.
Really, Cindy? So you're telling me that you haven't noticed that Nathan has a huge crush on you?
The fuck are you talking about, Jennifer? This is the last thing I need right now.
Go fuck yourselves, all of you! Leave me alone!
Shh. Jen, come back!
I'm gonna go pack.
What?
I'm getting the fuck out of here, even if I need to walk away!
Fuck! This is our fucking spare!
We're never gonna find anybody to fix this. We're 15 miles away from anywhere.
Fuck this shit! I'm leaving! Jen!
Nathan, tell me this wasn't you.
Mark, not the time.
Sure it was me. And I forgot to tell you, I also
drowned the old man!
I'm not fucking joking!
Fuck you! Fuck you!
Get up here. Keep it down. She just fell asleep.
You're the one who's in danger.
What are you? Come on. Listen.
Come on.
No, go.
Okay, stop. Go.
Mark, listen to me.
Mark, it was hard enough calming Jen down after a meltdown. What the hell is wrong with you?
Look at this.
This is a lie, Mark. It's bullshit. My grandfather was an honorable man.
Nathan, he wants you.
Who? You're starting to sound like that crazy old hag.
Wasn't it raining?
Did you see anything, man? Mark, look at this.
Nathan, look. How the hell did it end up here?
This fucker and end this.
Nathan?
There's nothing here, Mark.
Shh.
What are we doing
here?
Can
you shut up?
Did you hear that? What was that?
Nathan?
Hey, Mark, you good? Nathan? Nathan! Where are you?
Mark? Cindy? Cindy. 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 Cindy.
Dad? Dad? Where are you?
Cindy, I tried. I just wanted you to be safe, my darling. I had no idea it was going to end this way.
Cindy! Oh my gosh! Nathan! Mark!
Mark?
Nathan! Oh. Wake up! You're...
Oh, fuck. Oh. What was that?
You believe me now?
I just want my head back.
Let's go. Oh. Come on.
Jen! What happened?
My head. Where's Jen?
I don't know where she is.
Jen! Outside.
You guys, I'm scared.
Take it easy. We'll find her. She's gotta be around here somewhere.
It must have got Jen.
Shut up, Mark.
Nathan, we've just been attacked!
Attacked by what? Stop this madness.
She could be down by the lake or the creek.
No! Don't go with him!
Mark, she's my friend. She came here because of me.
I said no! It could be too dangerous and we'll wait till the morning to get help.
Good luck with that.
Are you crazy? What if she comes back? Cindy? Wait!
You wait! We're going to find Jen.
Shit. Jen! Have you seen Jennifer?
Jen!
I don't think your friend would be crazy enough to run off on her own at this hour, do you?
No.
I know. Jen, always giving me a hard time.
You knew what you were getting into, now live with it. Nate, when we find Jen, you should really give her a chance.
Chance?
Don't pretend to be stupid. You know what I'm talking about.
Maybe you're right. After all, my favorite isn't available.
What are you talking about?
You know.
Nate, we're here to find Jen, remember? Come on, let's go.
He will come for us. The drowned is free. And wants to avenge his death.
What does he want from us? Who killed him?
He was going to denounce old Drake. Will refused to accept that our commune was used as a front for drug farming. He ended up being thrown in the lake. Adam and Cindy's father didn't do anything to help him. Do you understand now? We all betrayed him. We were all seduced by the old man's scheme. When Will found out about it, he was incriminated by Nathan Drake.
That's why Nathan's in danger. Well, there must be a way to stop him. How did he even return?
Cindy's father could keep them away. But the gates have been opened by you.
The doll.
He has returned, and his hatred will grow stronger till he gets his revenge. The ritual made it so that his soul will never leave this place. I taught him how to use his hatred to keep him here.
You taught him?
I'm sorry. I was in love, and I didn't want to lose him. The hatred will keep him here.
Well, if you know the ritual, then you know how to stop him.
You have to free him. He's trapped, suffering. Free him.
How?
The receptacle that contains William's soul must be broken. You don't have much time.
Thank you.
It's nothing.
Beth told me everything, Cindy. William performed a ritual that keeps him alive. He's the drowned. And the only way to stop him is to break the clay vase.
You have got to be fucking kidding me.
I know where the vase is.
Don't you love me?
Thank you.
What are we gonna do?
Let's go.
Bye, Dad.